at you through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shimei Hashai, Bashem Rakakwadash. All praises and glories definitely do, especially in these times. Now, this is a video that was put up by Elder Yashawamba of Dallas, Texas. And the name of the video is called Holy Smokes. And the title comes from a comment that the brother on the right of your screen, which I believe he goes by the title Fresh. This is the Fresh and Fit podcast. The guy on the left, Myron Gaines, and you might have heard me mention his name. He goes by the title of Fit. And the guy on the right, I forgot his name, his real name. He goes by the title of Fresh. Okay, so when you put it together, Fresh and Fit podcast. Now, these two guys, they're out of Miami, right? And their podcast on YouTube is rising up in popularity. It's getting very popular. They even had a guest by the name of Andrew Tate, which I had did a video and I featured Andrew Tate, and he was on the panel, being interviewed by these couple of brothers there, which I believe the guy on the left, he said he's from the, Sudan. Well, his parents are from Sudan, I think he said, and he was raised up a so-called Muslim, but I don't believe he's an Arab. I believe he he's an Israelite, and definitely the guy on the right. I think his background is either from Ghana or Nigeria, one or the other. Anyway, to make a long story short, Elder Yashawamba did a video in bringing out an excerpt of these two guys here with the panel of females there, and it's customary for them to read the super chats that they receive. The super chats is the comments that people leave with money. You know, they donate money to these guys and they leave a comment, and they call them super chats. So one of the super chats that was read was a comment from, I forgot the guy's name, maybe in this clip the name will be mentioned, that the guy quoted Isaiah 4:1, that the day will come when seven women shall take hold of one man. And when the brother on the right heard that, his eyes were damn near ready to pop out of his head. He couldn't believe that was in the Bible. Hey, what these guys are going to find out is the most red pill book, because they call their knowledge red pill knowledge of how to combat feminism and how to, put women back in their place where they belong. They call that red pill knowledge. They're going to find out the most red pill book on the planet Earth is the Bible and the powerful knowledge that it contains. So without further ado, I'm going to play the part of Elder Yashawamba's video. And, he's going to go into it. You're going to hear Mr. Holy Smokes. That's the brother to your right. Fresh. You're going to hear Mr. Holy Smokes lose it when Myron Gaines read the scripture Isaiah 4:1 from the comment that somebody sent in the super chat. So without further ado, let's do this.
Shalom. Giving all praise to Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai Bahasham, Racha HaKodash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders at Great Millstone who rule well. And as always, we give peace and salutations unto the elect. And I just wanted to play this clip from this, pretty famous podcast up and coming. I just got put onto him about a month ago, Fresh and Fit. The Red Pill community, where you have these men starting these YouTube pages, all right? Pretty much, taking their manhood back, coming up against, this Western wicked, all right, mentality that has destroyed men, all right, and put women in positions that they feel are liberating, but it's actually destroying them and their value.
Yeah, that's true. One of the ways of destroying a society is empowering the women, putting them on the same status as men. That was proven in the ancient Roman Empire. That was one of the reasons that brought down ancient Rome. Now, of course, Rome has been revisited through this system, this kingdom, But there are many reasons that brought down ancient Rome, and one of them was empowering the women. Okay, now the scriptures tell us that a woman is not to usurp. Let's get the book of 1 Timothy, the second chapter. You know, the basic tenet, and I say this all the time, the basic tenet of feminism is that women are equal to men. That's not true, not according to scriptures. Okay, when you bring in the Holy Scriptures say something completely different. Okay, this is the book of 1 Timothy, the second chapter, 11th verse. Let's start there. It says, let the woman learn in silence with all subjection, but I suffer not a woman to teach, nor to usurp authority over the man. So there is no 50-50, okay, but to be in silence, right? For Adam was first formed, then Eve. There you go. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived, because she's the weaker vessel, was in the transgression. So that's just one of many scriptures which prove that the woman is not equal to the man. But in this Western society, this feminist society, they teach the women are equal to the men. In other words, whatever a man can do, a woman can do, and that's simply not true. All right, there are rules for the men as there are rules for the women. Okay, so let's get back to the video. So again, one of the ways to implode a society is to elevate the woman to the status of the man, give him equal rights, so to speak. And that's a recipe for disaster. All right, let's move on.
But we're not going to get too much into that, because all of those things can be found in the Holy Scriptures, and everything that these men say and that they think and that will fix what they're crying about, all right, and women as well, can be fixed via the Holy Scriptures. Okay,
that's right. That's why when Yahweh Shai comes back, what's going to be instituted in the planet Earth? What's going to be the standard of law? All right, the rule of law, the scriptures. All right, the Bible is a lot more than just a collection of stories that you feel good when you read on a cold winter's night. Okay, I'm trying to be dramatic with it. No, the Bible is a book of laws, statutes, and commandments. The greatest laws, statutes, and commandments on the planet Earth is found in the scriptures, the Bible. Okay, there are laws for the men, there are laws for the women, there are laws for the children. And those laws were given to the Lord's chosen people.